one thinks of this magnificent country, one cannot help but envision the Wanli Changcheng. The Great Wall. It once stretched like a mighty dragon across 4,000 miles of China. Welcome. I am Li Bai, a poet of the Tang Dynasty. And I have returned to share with you reflections of my beloved China. Like this great wall, it winds like a road across timeless landscapes. But one can also find landscapes that are ever changing. Shanghai, a city forever reinventing itself. Vibrant, sophisticated, romantic. As Shanghai reflects modern China, historic Nanjing Road reflects modern Shanghai. Set your gaze across the Huangpu River and you will find a new China that reaches for the sky. Yet in this city of East meets West, one can still find treasures of Shanghai's stately European influence. Even in the hectic pace of modern China, there is always time for Tai Chi, a tradition that has endured for centuries. Up here on Huangshan, at the Sea of Clouds, painters and poets like myself have been inspired for generations. In China, we say, a poem in every painting, and a painting in every poem.
We have had a long history. Much of it has been recorded in this fashion. However, it may be said that the history of the Chinese people is not written in ink, but with water.
The mighty Yangtze River. A fellow poet once wrote, traveling against the currents of the Yangtze is more difficult than climbing to heaven. That may have been once true, but no longer. The course of this great river, through mountains and valleys, touches the lives of 500 million Chinese. This ancient city sits on the longest man-made waterway in the world. When Marco Polo traveled this way, he called Suzhou the Venice of the East.
I suppose if I had traveled to Europe, they would now call Venice the Suzhou of the West.
So vast is China that even within her borders are many exotic lands and contrasts. From the serenity of Heavenly Lake to the busy night market of Urumqi. Here one discovers that Xinjiang province is home to many ethnic peoples with their own unique customs and their own unique cuisines. Years ago brought Marco Polo to these very gates. The gates of Jiayuguan, the extreme western end of the Great Wall. Inner Mongolia shows us the perfection of an earlier time. Here, the Mapping people still live much as they always have. Far to the south is Yunnan Province, home to many of China's national minorities. The cultures of this province are as diverse as the landscape. Like a sheer limestone forest, one of nature's unique wonders. In the far northeast is Heilongjiang. Although winter here can last 6 months, the people celebrate by carving magical sculptures of ice. Portuguese charm is once more within China's borders. Ah, Hong Kong, one of the most exciting cities on Earth. A city steeped in Western culture, but still uniquely Chinese. Even Hong Kong's buildings, thrusting ever skyward, reflect the city's vitality. Hong Kong, ever on the move. Yes, the Chinese landscape changes swiftly, but one can also find enduring legacies that reflect our past. Everywhere one sees our history, ancient treasures like the Nine Dragons Screen reflect our traditions. Dragons were a powerful symbol of the Emperor's authority. For centuries, the tombs of China's emperors have been watched over by these remarkable warriors of terracotta and these figures of stone. And for 800 years, this intersection of three rivers has been protected by a silent sentinel, the giant Buddha of Lishan. One can find a living legacy of China's past in the world-famous Peking Opera. The center of Beijing is perhaps China's greatest legacy, the Forbidden City. Imagine courtyards that could hold 100,000 members of the imperial court. For 500 years, this vast walled city was the home of 24 emperors. The sons of heaven. But today, all the world can pass through this gate. Tiananmen Square. To stand here is to stand at the heart of China. Playground for the emperor, but now it is a playground for all of China.
I have brought you to a place of unique beauty called Reed Flute Cave. The same forces that shaped these pillars of stone have done a more remarkable job directly above us.
Unsurpassed in all of China. Countless artists and poets have struggled to capture the whoever looks on this loses himself in eternity. We have seen many reflections of China, but the true face of China can be found in our people. Now come full circle.
Sadly, that means this is where we must part. But I hope you will return to China someday. A wave of the hand now, and I am gone. Lowering my head, I dream that I am home. Until we meet again, Saijian.
4 o'clock.
Thank you.